If you're taking a statin, or if someone you know is taking a statin, and that includes most of us, either we have a family member or those of us that are in our middle ages, most of us are on statins. You need to be aware of this. Not all statins are created equal. We've talked about it multiple times. Lipitor is the most commonly prescribed statin. Why? Because the standards basically focus on using statins to decrease cholesterol. Now, what's the problem with that? Half the people that have a heart attack and stroke don't have high cholesterol. So maybe it's something else. And yes, it is something else. We know that. It's cardiovascular inflammation. We've made a lot of information available. We've given a free digital course out to viewers of this channel. It's available on our website. You can take a look to see if you have what's really killing people, and that is CV inflammation. Now, as we said, not all statins are created equal in dealing with both of those issues. Lipitor, the most commonly used statin, is great at lowering your LDL, but it's not so good at managing CV inflammation or cardiovascular inflammation. Now, how do we know that? There are studies out there that have begun to show this information. One of the key studies was called the Meteor Study. It's actually not the Meteor Study itself, but a reanalysis of that Meteor Study. And again, as some of this conversation started coming up on the YouTube channel with Matt Kelly, John Lorscheider, Edward Kwong, several others, it made me realize I've been meaning to do this like so many other things. I've been meaning to do this series for a long time. The Jupiter study, the Meteor reanalysis, several other studies with some updated literature reviews, science, looking at are all statins created equal, and is it the decrease in LDL, or is it cardiovascular inflammation? So this is one of those studies in that series. This was in the Annals of Internal Medicine back in 2010, I think. Again, not a recent study at all. This is one of the classics. Yes, 2010. It was a C-reactive protein lowering with rosuvastatin in the Meteor study, Peters and Associates. Now, what's the point here? Let's, at least in terms of the study question. The study question was, okay, we know that most statins lower both cholesterol, LDL, bad cholesterol, and we know that most statins lower cardiovascular inflammation as measured by CRP, C-reactive protein. But some of them are not as good at doing both as others, as in the Lipitor that we talked about. So how could they go back and tease this out? Well, here's what they did in the Meteor reanalysis. They thought through the logic like this. Look, we know that they have rosuvastatin, Crestor, generic, has impact in both areas. If we go back and analyze it, is this going to correlate? Both cholesterol lowering and CRP lowering are going to happen overall on a population basis. But will it happen in the same degree in each patient? In other words, in some patients where you get a little bit of LDL lowering, but can you get a lot of CRP lowering? If that's the case, then it's not the same mechanism. That's one of the things, one of the assumptions that many people had. Well, of course you get lower CRP because you lowered LDL. Wrong. That was not the case. And that's what this study shows. So we'll go through a few details on it for those of you who, number one, don't believe me. Number two, you're interested in getting into the details, and you know, maybe you're science geeks. We got a lot of those on this channel. So the methods, METEOR is a randomized placebo-controlled trial that evaluated the effect of 40 milligrams of rosuvastatin on a two-year change in CIMT, carotid intima media thickness. 40 is a lot. Like I said, and I've said in many other videos, I will routinely start somebody on 5 and usually be able, once we get the patient calmed down, their the CV inflammation calmed down, get them to 2.5 or even 2.5 twice a week. Now, here's a key point to note. These were 984 low-risk patients on 10-year Framingham risk. In other words, for somebody that we know is at high risk, CIMT and some of the other subtleties that we're looking at here, they're not an issue. You know somebody needs to get, they need to lose weight. You know they need to stop smoking. You know that you need to get their blood pressure under control. These are people that already have all those things under control. And they still have some problems. Elevated CRP, maybe some, these people evidently did not have increased cholesterol values. So here's the results. Rosuvastatin lowered CRP significantly compared with placebo. Well, that's not a surprise. 36% in the rosuvastatin group versus no change in the placebo group. Again, not a surprise. If you haven't seen that time and time again, look at some of the other videos that we've got out there, like the Jupiter trial video. But here's the thing. There was no relationship in change between CRP and cholesterol. Stratified analysis showed that CRP lowering effect was present among all strata of baseline characteristics, including baseline lipids and CRP levels. However, the magnitude of CRP reduction was larger amongst women and participants older than 60 years old. That's another critical thing to be aware of. Lipitor, again, doesn't appear to work as well in women. It doesn't appear to work as well in those of us with insulin resistance. And wait a minute, what's the number one cause of cardiovascular inflammation? Insulin resistance. So the conclusion for the study was rosuvastatin 40 lowered CRP independently from its effects on cholesterol in low-risk subjects with normal baseline CRP and moderate CIMT. Now here's a couple of other points. The elevated level of CRP, inflammatory marker, is a strong predictor of cardiovascular events. We've already seen that in other studies. Even in the absence of hyperlipidemia, we've already seen that in other studies. And furthermore, CRP is a strong predictor of cardiovascular events than cholesterol. And if you didn't know that, maybe you should look at some of the other videos we've got. Treatment of elevated CRPs seems to be of great importance in prevention. Again, this is repetitive. The object of the study was to investigate relationship between CRP lowering and LDL in the METEOR study using CIMT and lab studies. In essence, the METEOR study, as I said, had already been done. And this goes into some of the statistical methods they used to analyze that. The thing that I talked about earlier is, you know, we got a decrease in both LDL and CRP in both populations. But when you look at the individuals, was it the same degree? And the answer was no. Rosuvastatin treatment was associated with a 36% reduction in CRP level, a 49% reduction in cholesterol, LDL, a 34% reduction in total cholesterol, and an 8% increase in HDL. A 16% reduction in triglycerides. So significant numbers. Here's the values on the study. And here's the key thing that I wanted to just repeat. Evidence of a dual mechanism for benefit of statins, lipid lowering, and a reduction in inflammation has important implications for current and future treatment of atherosclerosis. Well, now, why is that? Current guidelines emphasize the use of lipid-lowering therapies to reach targets of LDL cholesterol. Now, In other words, again, your docs often look, usually looking at cholesterol levels. However, individual agents differ in their ability to reduce the levels of inflammatory markers. So even a doc who understands that, yeah, and that's where most docs are these days, they understand that, well, CV inflammation has something to do with it. But I'm giving them Lipitor, and Lipitor lowers LDL. So what's the problem? Why are you so focused on this? Again, here's the problem. Individual agents differ in their ability to reduce the levels of inflammatory biomarkers. Therefore, accordingly, the study raises the provocative question of the effects of statins on CRP, as well as cholesterol, should be considered in decisions regarding therapy. Moreover, as we saw with the Jupiter trial, statin therapy should be initiated, not might, should be initiated in individuals with elevated CRP levels, but normal cholesterol. Again, as we saw before, that's what we're talking about. We're talking about people that your doc would say, look, you're lower than 10% on your Framingham risk. If you have made it this far, thank you for your interest.